is the greatest defense against the evil one. Then he says, verse 15, stand then firm with the belt of truth around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with the feet that are fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. So, the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace, or the preparation of the gospel of peace, that is KJV. KJV says a preparation of the gospel of peace. Is here represented as a protective shoes worn by the Roman soldier. No soldier can effectively fight in a battle without these specially tailored, or if there's anything like cobbled shoes. Cobbler is the one who makes shoes, right? In my class 4, English, not geography. Cobbler shoes, right? Now, look at it this way. The gospel, let's go back to definition a little. Let's go back to English. What is definition of prepare? Here it says, to make ready beforehand for purpose of use or activity. Right? The readiness. So, you are prepared to be ready. Right? Now, for you to be ready, there is a sequence of everything, right? To make ready beforehand. So what makes you ready beforehand is the gospel of truth. Because if you do not have this gospel of truth, you will be not ready to go and spread this gospel of truth. If you do not have this gospel of truth, you will be not ready to live according to the gospel of truth. If you do not have the gospel of truth, you shall not demonstrate the righteousness of Jesus Christ in our talks. The righteousness, the breastplate of righteousness, covers our hearts, as we have seen, so that even our talks, the Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Hallelujah. The righteousness covers us so much, such that even the talks that we have to think, we have to talk, and the meditation of our hearts and everything we do, all of them are covered by the blood, the word of God. It trains us how we're going to speak. It trains us how we're going to think. And it makes us ready now. It gives us now the strength to move forward with our works and spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. Readiness is before. Hallelujah. Before you go to work, definitely you have to be ready. Right? You don't get to work and then be ready. That's exactly what Christians want to do this day. I want to come in the pulpit. I want to hold responsibilities in the kingdom of God. Well, I don't know even who Jesus Christ is. Utaumwa. You'll be gotten right. Right? You can't go to physical war. You can never go. Even the army. By the way, even the army. That's this talk about the world. Right? Even the army. Before it takes you now to go to the battle, you have to be trained. Right? It's only in the kingdom of God that people just want to. And then you say, oh, the Spirit of God is going to be with me. Okay. Do you know even how he speaks? Do you know even how God speaks? Right? Do you know the basics? Do you apply the basics of the word of God? And when there's Bible study, nobody wants to come. Those are the things that actually equip us. Gives us the shoes in the readiness. Hallelujah. Hiya. Am I not vibaya? Am I saying something that is not right? Am I in my own world? Hallelujah. Yeah, I'll select a verse that even I don't understand how to apply it in my own vow. I'm being blinded that I'm speaking on something that actually I am living it. See how the devil can do? Right? Because I was not prepared beforehand. If I'm not prepared, I'll speak anything. It will bless you, yet. But myself, It will leave me the same way because I'll just become like a radio. A radio tells you, eat this and that and that and that. It will, you will eat and do everything, but it will left, be left there. When you switch off the car, it will bless you with music. And even it will catch you emotionally with the songs. Even with tears. Right? It will bring you even presence of God. When you're worshiping and you put some song there, you feel, yeah, your song imenipeleka ikanifikisha. It has taken me even to the presence of God. That thing has actually ushered me. Right? But you know what? When you switch off the radio, it's there. Tomorrow, it will be singing, depending on the tune, it will be singing some other songs that even you don't want even to listen. With words that you don't want even to hear as a Christian. Why? It's just a vessel. It's not transformed. And that's exactly what happens, we Christians. If we are not prepared with the word of God, the Bible study that people run away from, there is no way you can understand God without studying the word of God. Even the world, you can never become a doctor without going to the classes. Can you drive someone? Minister Seth, will you give me your car to drive if you know that I don't know how to drive a car? And why do you want us to do that about the things of God? Why do I want to serve God effectively, right, every year? And by February, March, you are done. Why? Because you're staying away from the thing that can bring you to the presence of God and can transform you and give you that righteousness that we all desire. Hallelujah. I'm open to, if I talk bad, please just tell me, this guy, you know, please. So, put on the proper state of mind. Readiness is to put on. It put, you know, to put on the proper state of mind. This one is the word that can actually describe who the devil is and his actions are and what he's capable of doing. And in that way, it gives you the ability to know your enemy beforehand. And you're staying out of it. That's the reason why you don't have the power even want to come to church. It doesn't make sense. Hallelujah. It wouldn't make sense. Well, you know, if I don't understand geography, why should I go to that class? But if I desire to know what geography, by the way, geography is beautiful. If I desire to see what geography is, do you know what? That class, I'll not miss it. I'll never miss it. And as I go to that class, it gives me the power to become a teacher of geography. When you read the word of God, the Spirit of God does something in you, makes you understand the word of God so that you can actually share the word of God. It's not for people, no. It's everybody, because he said, go ye to the world and spread the gospel. He didn't say such specific people. It's everybody. Everybody who believes. Win, disciple, send. Go spread the gospel. Go live like Jesus Christ. That on its own, that's the reason why we are here. Live like Jesus Christ. Let the breastplate, the righteousness of God, and we saw that in the book of Isaiah 57, that God, his own character, won his enemies, over his enemies. We saw in the Revelation that God spoke, right? He spoke. Don't think that this world will be destroyed by what? By nuclear and everything everybody is afraid of. No, we still have another 1,000 years to live here. It's not going to be another place. So don't be afraid of anything, no. We are coming here 1,000, that's what the Bible says, 1,000 years. He will rule here in this world, right? Because he's powerful, right? And then he says, I sometimes get excited and get out of topic, sorry. So, what is readiness? Is to work out the detail of and plan in advance. It's a, you know what? In the war, in the military, we plan wars. Right? Just don't wake up and say, let's go to war. First and foremost, even Jesus said, anybody who's trying to start a project, you have to sit down and see whether I'm going to do this. Am I having the power? Right? And if maybe a certain king has called on a war, you sit down and you count the cost. And see, am I gonna, can I counter this guy? And if you cannot counter, just say, hey, you know what? What's your take? What do you want? Let's finish this thing. Let's talk about this thing. Right? That's exactly what it is in the spiritual. We have to sit down and plan in advance. You cannot plan without staying outside the word of God. The generals who are here, how to win this war, the maneuvers of how to win this war are exactly here. And first and foremost, if you do not know that you are at war, hakuna haja ya vita then. Do you first and foremost know that you are in a war? Right? If Christians don't know that we are at war, then why should you take the, it's peace every time? That's the peace that the evil one wants you to understand. Right? With the different, you know, if I get this primary, I know I can get this and that and that and that. And then I end up tying myself. You know, the devil does not offer any solutions. Let me give you one story here. You know about Moses and Pharaoh? You know that contention? Moses makes a snake, and Pharaoh magicians make a snake. Moses does sends out nuts, and the same do. They do the same. They make blood, water becomes, the river Nile becomes water, they do the same. Right? Do you know the pattern? That was copying. He never came up with a solution. If the snake went down and he killed it, that's a different way. If the gnats came and the frogs came and he destroyed them, the magicians destroyed them, that's a different thing. But now the devil was trying even to make even Pharaoh think that he has any equal power. By, because, you know, duplicating, and we think that he has power, nothing. Bring a solution. God brings solution. The evil one doesn't have any solution. From beginning, that's what we see. And we are caught up with these little things here. This has gone. This. No. He's just doing the same way he has been doing before. God brings a permanent solution. And that's the reason why I'm saying, for us to bring a permanent solution, we have to stay together with this God who gives permanent solutions. Hallelujah. And then what does readiness do? It puts us together. Remember what we said about the belt? Gathers everything together. This word brings our minds together. Before we go to war, we have to be in one mind. Otherwise, if we cannot do that, spreading even the gospel, we cannot do that. Why? Because we are not controlled. We are not speaking in one voice. That's the voice of God. Hallelujah. Readiness. So, bringing the power together. And that power, bringing that readiness, is brought by the truth of the gospel. That's the reason why the belt brings up everything together, harnesses everything together, and gives you the ability now to march and do whatever you want to do freely. The truth of the word of God takes away any doubts that have been hanging around, right? And makes you even lighter. When you see somebody, when he's born again, he feels as if the luggage has gone down. Because the devil has been planting very many things. And you are carrying a lot of things in your mind that even you do not want to do. But once you know the truth of God, and you know the truth of the word of God, then he says, wow, I feel lighter. I have the joy. Because you know the truth and somebody has taken away that load. Hallelujah. Now, that way now, you have been brought together. Your mind has been brought together. So that, you know what? Now to study the word of God and concentrate with the common enemy. Right? Yes. Go take the shoes of the, you know, those the one for, you know, the guys who play golf with spikes. And pray for them and say that now you're advancing. Because I have those shoes that cannot. The word of God, once you have the word of God, in the book of Revelation, the truth is always advancing. The Revelation 19. When Christ is advancing, he's advancing, he's not coming back. He's moving ever forward. Advancing forward. Because there's nothing that can stop him. There's nothing that can stop this word. If we embrace this word of God, there's nothing that can stop us on the way. Because we know who we are. And the greater I am, dwells in us. Hallelujah. So, prepare is a prescription. What does it do? It gathers your mind together and puts in that attitude of readiness to face the common task that is ahead of us as the children of God. There's nothing that prepares us like the readiness of the word of God, the word of truth. Hallelujah. So the idea of preparation is really readiness. We must be mobile, Right? We must be flexible. God performed a miracle this way, and you keep waiting from that same way. Yeah, you will wait. We can never understand how God does things. We need to understand the move of how God is doing things. Right? And also, he can still do the same way. He's God. Ours is to have that good frequency so that when he moves, when he talks, Even when you cannot just say that he speaks just here. No. He can speak even when in the house. And when he speaks, you say, no, that voice, it is him. Right? And I'm going to act because I've heard that voice, it is him. Right? So it does what? It's flexible and ready and ready with the truth. We must be mobile. That is the army. We have must be mobile. The army does not put on those shoes just to stay. They put on so that they can advance. Hallelujah. And gather stamina and, you know, stay in a, you know, stability. He says that we must be mobile, flexible, and ready with the of truth. As Christians, we have to live in a constant readiness and flexibility. Hallelujah. Now, the gospel provides the footing for everything we do in the kingdom of God. Now, here, however powerful the rest of the body is, however powerful the righteousness of Christ is in you, right? However much truth that you're having, right? If the feet, you're not able to understand and even move the gospel the way it's supposed to be, it's a matter of time. However the rest of the body is, if you are wounded in your feet, right? You are an easy prey to the enemy. Ukishikiwa hapa, right? You start advancing, we start advancing gospel of the Nicolaitans. Right? The Nicolaitans. That's in the book of Revelation chapter 2, right? The Nicolaitans. We'll talk about these guys sometimes to come. So, and of course, when he was spreading the gospel, he thought that he's doing good. But in one way or another, the church at Ephesus, because they were rooted so well by Paul in the word of God, they said, this guy, this word is not truth. And Christ says, yeah, I know your ways. I know you don't like the ways of Nicolaitans. That is good. When Christ knows that we have the truth and we can actually stand and say, I'm not going to follow this because it's not in the word of God, he says, good. Hallelujah. Not every wind of doctrine comes and then, oh, oh, today we are doing this. No. Isaiah 52:7. As I finish, in fact, I'm finishing now. Paul probably had this verse in mind when he referred to the feet that are being, the feet that are being fitted with the feet, your feet being fitted with the shoes. Right? Look at this, what he says. How beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news. Hallelujah. How beautiful are the feet, on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news. Who proclaim peace, who bring tidings, good tidings, and who proclaim salvation, who say to Zion, your God reigns. Now, let's look at it this way. How beautiful are they who bring good news? You cannot take this good news to anybody if you do not know it. If you spread the true gospel of God, it is capable, and not it's capable, it will. What does it do? It will proclaim peace. Hallelujah. Because the peace that surpasses any understanding shall govern our hearts, because it is the peace that is the truth. We have known the truth. And then what else? It will bring good tidings, and it will proclaim salvation. The true word of God. Peace, good tidings, and salvation. Because we have been ready with the true gospel of the word of God. who proclaim salvation and say, hey, you know what? Our God reigns. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, these people cannot take this good news if they do not have even they do not know what the word of God is. For you to go and speak effectively the word of God, know it. It's not through school, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. Let the Spirit of God, we are all students. Nobody is a champion in this world. We are all students. We are learning every day. And the proper learning of the word is when we demonstrate, hey, attendance in a class of engineering or whichever course you are doing will not make you an engineer. It's if they are tested and you talk like an engineer, you walk like an engineer, you reason like an engineer, then you shall be given the mandate to work as an engineer, to be entrusted that you are an engineer, and even to teach engineering. Hallelujah. Spend time with the word of God. Then you'll be fitted with the feet. You'll be ready, made ready to spread the gospel of truth. The righteousness of God shall be abiding in you. The truth of God shall abide in you. Now, when you're that way, now when you start taking, you know, now you cannot. It's not a, and be given. No, it says, and then take. Why? Because the truth is in you. The righteousness of Christ is working in you. So you have been brought to a position whereby you can make a choice of, let me take an armor of faith, let me take the shield of faith and the sword of the Spirit. Go with it. No, I need it. I take it. And you make a choice. Because the Spirit of God is working in you. And may God bless you. I love you in Jesus' name. Forgive me, probably. But, you know. God bless you guys. I love you in Jesus' name.
Let us stand up in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Our Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you. We are calling on you, Holy Spirit of God, you who puts the desire in the hearts of your people to thirst and to hunger for the word of God. It's only by knowing the word of God that will be, my Father, effective witnesses of the truth. But if we don't know the word of God, if we don't spend time with the word of God, we cannot be effective witness. Father, you desire us to know you, because, Lord, when we know your word, we'll be knowing you. O Holy Spirit of God, how I pray, put a desire in our hearts. Put an appetite of the word of God in our hearts. Help us, Holy Spirit of God, to desire deep within us, to study more, to pray more, so that you can reveal your word to us, O God, that we can be effective in our lifestyles, that we can be effective, Lord, my Father, in our homes, when our children, the people around us look at us, they will see a transformed people because we are doing what Jesus would do. When we are in the community will see a people who are transformed, a people who are changed, because Holy Spirit of God, you have equipped us with the word of God, and we desire the word. Help us, Holy Spirit of God. So tonight, Lord, as your people, the speaker has spoken to us, oh God, you have spoken to us using your servant. But Lord, it will only take us and our minds to desire to change. Put the desire in us, Lord. We spend time on many things that do not profit us in any way. We spend time watching TV. We spend time talking. We spend time on Facebook. We spend time in many places, even, Lord, in WhatsApp, just reading things that are not helpful. But Lord, you are telling us, if only we can spend time in your word, if we can spend time studying your word, Holy Spirit of God, you are willing to reveal the word of God to us, and you reveal the mind of God through you, through the word of God to our lives. Help us, O God. Even those people who are listening online, and even those people who will listen these recordings after we are done with these, Lord, I pray, put a desire in all of us to submit to this word and to desire to seek you in your word, O God, so that we can become effective people, effective witnesses, wherever we will be. We surrender our lives to you. Lord Almighty, we remember our brethren who are not in the house today. I pray, my Father, even them, put that desire in them, because you desire us to grow together as a body and as children of God. We commit the man to thy hands. We also pray, Lord, for those people who are out there and they are struggling with issues of life. There are people who are sick. King of glory, we are speaking divine healing. We remember members of this body who are not well. Jehovah, I pray, wherever they are, Lord, I speak healing upon their bodies in the name of Jesus Christ, that they will rise up again strong in you, O God. Because the word of God tells us, by your stripes we were healed. I declare healing upon their bodies. Father, even those, Lord, who have received information that they have got terminal illness, I pray, O God, you can heal any type of disease. Reach out to them and heal them, because you are good God. Father, even those who are struggling with other matters of life and they feel they need you, oh my Father, get involved in that, in the situations they are in. Even those who are trusting you because they have exams and other things that are ahead of them that need your intervention, Lord, I pray that you interfere in the name of Jesus. We pray even, Lord, for the struggles that are in Eastern Europe. How I pray that, Lord, you get involved and you bring peace, because you are the Prince of Peace. We know, Lord, without you the world has no peace. But Jehovah, if you intervene, Jesus, you are the Prince of Peace, and victory of mankind can only come in one way, through our Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you this night. So even as we go home, we are going home with one desire, that we need to study more. We need to hear from you more. We need to surrender to the Holy Spirit of God more, that he can lead us and guide us and bring us to the praise where we need to be. We commit our lives to you, and even the service of the services of Sunday, we commit them unto thy hands, Father. Jehovah, the Swahili service, we pray that again you shall gather us together and you shall nourish us in your word. And even the English service, Lord, where we shall be dedicating children, we pray that your presence will be in this house in a big way. And even in the Kikuyu service at the end, where, Lord, we shall be, my Father, praising and doing kegosho, I pray that your mighty presence will manifest. We thank you. So we, as we go home, watch over us and bless us. We commit our lives to you, for it is in Jesus' name we do pray and believe. And God's people say,
amen.
God's people say,
amen.
Amen. May the Lord bless you. May he do you good. Let's say the words of grace together. And now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives. We shall dwell in the presence of God and in the house of God forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord bless you. Let us appreciate the man of God for the good work that he has done this evening. Amen. God bless you, sir. You have blessed us. Amen. God bless you. You can go home in peace.